This is a railgun.
2, 1, fire.
And this is the closest we've come to making one. In real life, it fires a shell at over 5,000 miles per hour, 8,000 kilometers per hour, and pierces concrete 100 miles away. But it has one fatal flaw. Because the hypersonic railgun is so powerful, it damages itself whenever it shoots a projectile after a few rounds. It requires heavy repairs and maintenance. We'll explain this in a minute, but first, let's talk about the General Atomics Hypersonic Blitzer. Railgun, described as Star Wars technology by researchers, is by far the most advanced weapon system humans have been able to develop. It's going to change naval and ground warfare forever. It doesn't use propellants, there's no gunpowder, and yet the shell reaches speeds of up to Mach 7, and the projectile can pierce through 6 layers of steel without a problem. Since the beginning of the 21st century, General Atomics has been working on developing the railgun, and the US government has spent $500 million on this project so far. In 2016, the Pentagon announced that another round of $800 million of government money would be spent on developing this technology. Why all of the money would be spent on turning the railgun into a defensive weapon? They wanted to adapt existing guns to enable them to fire the gunpowderless projectiles. The first test happened in October 2009 in San Diego, California. Every year since the first test, the company requested more funding, and they received more money. The US military wanted this railgun built, but they weren't going to haggle over a couple of million dollars. However, all this changed in 2021. You see, in 2021, General Atomics didn't ask for additional funding, knowing that they hadn't equipped any ship or land vehicle. With the railgun, people started smashing that like button, just like you should, if you haven't done so already. But no, in all seriousness, people started speculating that the project had failed. They thought the government should cut the funding and put the money to better use. But this might not be entirely true. I'll tell you why in a minute. For now, let's talk about some of the facts tied to the electromagnetic railgun. In the past, every battleship was equipped with cannons. They were responsible for taking down enemy ships, but were only effective at close range.